We are back again with a brand new video, and guys, in today's video, we've got a sprinter. We have got an 100 meter sprinter in today's video, and that's a little joke. But in today's video, guys, we are going to be reviewing none other than the 85 rated right winger that plays for Wolverhampton Wanderers. It's Adama Traore, and this is his scream card. But guys, before we get into today's video, I want to thank you all for all the support you've been showing on the channel recently. You've all been smashing the subscribe button, you've all been showing love, hitting the like button and commenting on the video. And guys, I really appreciate that. But we've set a target to hit 4,000 subscribers on the channel. I'm currently on 3,700 subscribers. And guys, if you're new around here, please smash that subscribe button and just help me to reach my target. I would really appreciate it if you could do that. So without any further ado, let's get in to today's video. 85 rated Adama Traore. If you want to pick this guy up on PlayStation, it's going to cost you 325,000 coins. If you want to pick him up on Xbox, it's going to cost you 315,000 coins. And guys, on PC, it's the cheapest, and this is very odd because, as you know, most PC players, they pay an absolute premium for cards. But Traore is the cheapest on PC. I don't understand this at all. 308,000 coins. So, initially, what do I think about the price tag? Well, guys, he's a very expensive player in the game, and in my opinion, I do think he's going to drop in price. I think over the next couple of weeks, once the hype actually goes down with this player, I think so will his price tag, because he's got a lot of pace, he's got physicality, shooting isn't the worst, and he's got good dribbling. But guys, I don't know, let's just get into the review, into the pace. What do we need to say about the pace? Absolutely fast. I don't actually think I've used a faster player in any FIFA. Honestly, guys, I've used Salah. I've used I've just used fast players, and there's no faster player than Adama Traore. Guys, 99 acceleration and 98 sprint speed. If you have this player getting behind, it's just game over for your defense. It really is. If you can get Traore by a opposition defender, or just past a different player that's your opposition's player, obviously, it's just game over for your opposition, because no defender is catching this card. You could have Varane, you could have Eder Militao, you could have whoever you want as a centre-back, Rio Ferdinand. If Adama Traore gets past that player, then there's no catching that player up. Guys, Traore, he's just fast. I'm going to keep reiterating this throughout the video. There is no faster player than Traore. If you like speed in this game, then Traore is your man. Getting into the shooting stats, 80 attack positioning, quite good. I've got to be honest, the majority of the time, he's trying to get in behind. If you play him as a right winger, he's trying to get in behind on that left back position. And I really like that about the card, guys, because for somebody with pace, he really knows how to use it. If you've got that Theo Walcott, again, guys, he's another fast player, but his attack positioning, I don't think it's the best. He doesn't try and get in behind, you sort of have to force him. But with Adama Traore, he does it for you. 77 finishing, 98 shot power, and 73 for long shots. So he's got the shot power. He's finishing of 77. You might want to boost that. Maybe you put a shooting chem style on to try and boost that. That's something I will probably suggest. But all in all, is he shooting good? You will see me score goals with Traore, but he's not a clinical finisher. Guys, you could play this guy as a striker. You could start him off as a right winger and then in-game move him into the striker position. Is he going to do you a job? Yes, 100% Traore will do you a job. But guys, he's not clinical. If you want a clinical striker, somebody like Icon Crespo, somebody like Play with the Month Lewandowski, then go for that player. But if you just want pace, if you just want pace ability, and first striker to score you the odd goal, then Traore might be your man. So, you might be thinking, I don't know why I said so like that, but you might be thinking, can he pass? Would you play this guy as a cam? So let's talk about that then. 72 vision, 81 short pass and 66 long pass. His short passing isn't the worst. I did try a couple of 1-2s with Adama Traore and he pulls them off quite well. However, if you're looking for that pinpoint passer that's going to sit in that cam position and thread through balls through to your strikers, then Traore just isn't that man. I would want Traore to be on the end of a pass, not to be the guy passing the ball. So if you're thinking about a cam, then rule this Traore out of that position. But guys, the dribbling on this card is really, really good. And I like that about the card because some fast players in the game, well, they're just fast. If you look at Inaki Williams, he's just pace. And he's not got the dribbling to boot. However, this Traore card, he really has the dribbling to boot. He's got the pace, he's got the dribbling. 88 agility, 91 balance, 83 ball control, and 93 dribbling. Guys, I've got to be honest, the fast agile players in FIFA 20, like I say in most of my videos, well, they're the meta, they are the best players. And Adama Traore in this game, he's fast, he's agile, he's got great balance. He is basically the meta in this game. Now, physically, you might be thinking, is Adama Traore strong? Because you've seen that physical stat on the base of his card. And you might be thinking, he's going to have crazy strength. Well, guys, you would not be wrong. 89 strength on this card. And one-on-one with the opposition, Traore most of the time comes out best. But guys, I've got to be honest, when he's coming up against centre-backs like Van Dijk or Varane, the aggression really plays a part with this Traore. And sometimes, it's just like he can't be bothered to win the ball back. 68 aggression. He's not aggressive in the slightest. And like I say, guys, if he loses the ball and you try and run after the centre-backs and try and jostle to get the ball back, it's just like he can't be bothered. He's just not aggressive in the slightest. So, Adama Traore, he's got a defensive card. He's got a right wing back or a right back card. And guys, you might be thinking, well, can this player defend as well? Can this Halloween card defend as well as that right wing back card? No, guys, it can't. 48 stand tackle, 44 slide tackle, and 39 interceptions. Do not play this guy defensively. I think he can help you out defensively, though. That pace is going to come into play because you're going to be able to chase down opposition very easily. But he's not got the defensive capabilities to play in a defensive position. So, guys, we've spoken about the price. We've spoken about the stats. I need to give you my overall thoughts and an overall rating on this Adama Traore card. So, let's go to my overall thoughts. My overall thoughts on this card is, he is very fast. He is very, very quick. And he's fantastic at dribbling. When he's in front of goal, it's hit and miss. Sometimes he hits the back of the net easily, but the majority of the time, it's on target, but the keeper is easily able to make a save. So, yeah, guys, as a winger, what would I suggest? I would suggest maybe playing him as a winger. I probably would play him as a striker if you need a super sub. If you're in foot champs and you're, I don't know, 2-1 down, and you're thinking, my opposition's defence, well, it's lacking some stamina, and I could really do with a fast player to bring on in that striker position just to cause some problems, then Traore will definitely be your man. But overall, do I think he's worth the price tag of 300,000 coins? Guys, not in the slightest. I think this card could easily drop down to around 150 to probably 170 in the next couple of weeks. So if you're hoping to buy this Traore card in the next couple of days, just know that in future, you will lose a lot of coins just by doing that. So, we go to my overall rating for this Adama Traore card. So my overall rating based on his performance, based on his price tag, is going to be an 8.4 out of 10. And you might be thinking, that's not a bad rating, because guys, it isn't. I think the rating's low down to his price tag. Enjoyment, yeah, I really enjoyed using this card. He's very fast and you can easily annoy your opposition with this player. But I think the price tag, it's just too hyped at the moment. This player is just overhyped at the moment and that's why his price tag is so high. Like I say, in the next couple of weeks, you're going to see a massive decline in that price. So guys, that's going to be it for today's video. If you've enjoyed the video of Vapchow today, so to wait, don't forget to leave a like. And guys, as always, if you're new around here, you like daily FIFA content, you like player reviews, you like absolutely anything to do with FIFA, you know what to do. Smash that subscribe.